Hey guys, Paolo from GongaChops.com here. Welcome back to our quick tip lesson series. Now, I just want to remind you that these lessons are geared towards players with a bit of experience. So if you're completely new to the instrument, take a second to swing by GongaChops.com and check out our Gongas 101 course before you jump in. And if you haven't already, make sure you hit like and subscribe and turn on your notifications for the channel so you know when our next lesson drops. Today we're going to check out a simple figure that can be used in different dynamic sections of an arrangement depending on the intention that we play it with. Now, intention is one of our most important and defining characteristics as musicians. Being deliberate about how we want something to sound and feel should always be present when we play. Now, this can be something simple that we can implement quickly, like choosing the volume at which you play a certain phrase or fill, as well as where it's coming from or what it's leading into. Or it can be something that takes years of practice to develop, like having unwavering laser focus when locking into a groove. In this lesson, we're going to work on a similar shape in all three examples, but the intention that we play them with will define their use. So for this first variation, we're going to work on a 4-bar phrase where all we'll do is play a low drum muffled tone on beat 4 in the 4th bar, followed by a low drum open tone on the downbeat of the following bar. And let's use our 2 drum tumbao in 2-3 clave as the foundation. So one way we can think of this figure is as something I like to call a transitional fill, which can basically refer to any short phrase that we can use to help us move from one section to another in an arrangement, or to help us reinforce or delineate a particular section in the form of a song, much like a timbal player uses his or her abanico or certain accents to do the same. Now this particular fill can be used to help us transition up from a down section, down from an up section, to initiate a call or response in relation to another instrument, or just as a variation within the tumbao to help us emphasize the downbeat of a specific bar, all depending on our intention. So in terms of the intention we play it with, it can be used to signal a change in dynamics from soft to loud or loud to soft, or something we want to keep at a relatively similar volume within our tumbao pattern simply as an accent if we're using it as a variation. So let's move on to working on a small variation on this phrase that commonly serves the same purpose as the one we just worked on. Again, all depending on our intention. Now all we're going to do is move our low drum muffled tone from beat 4 over to the end of 4. So this figure can be used in any way we deem fit, as long as we're deliberate with our intention. Now in this last example, I simply played it as part of the groove, keeping it at a relatively similar volume within the tumbao pattern. And to accommodate our tumbao, I switched up the sticking in the 4th bar and played tip, ghost, palm, tip, leading up to our muffled tone to make it easier to get over to the low drum with our right hand. So let's work on one more simple variation by adding another low drum muffled tone, this time on the end of 3. And again, this is something that we can use to help us transition up from a down section, down from an up section, or as a response to a call or phrase initiated by another instrument. But for now, let's just work on it as a variation within the groove. So for this last example, I want us to work on the difference between what it feels like to use these phrases to transition up versus transitioning down. So let's focus on the first example in this lesson and combine it with our most recent one as part of an 8-bar phrase. Now in the first 4 bars, we'll play a 1 drum tumbao as if we were in the down section of an arrangement, and then use our first fill to transition up in the 4th bar to a 2 drum tumbao where we'll also add a bongo bell. From there, we'll play our most recent variation in the 8th bar to transition back down to our 1 drum tumbao. Let's check it out.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So you can hear that the role and function of these simple variations can change entirely depending on our intention. If we want to use them to transition up, we need to play them with a dynamic shape from soft to loud to help us move to that higher intensity section. And the opposite is also true. To help us transition from up to down, we'll need to prepare the following section with a change in dynamics from loud to soft. This is ultimately something that you'll develop a feel for the more you listen to and analyze different players, songs, and styles. So now that you have some of these things in mind, try to see if you can spot where they're used as you're listening to your favorite recordings. Now, of course, these are just a couple of the endless amounts of different figures that we can use that serve the same purpose. So as you're listening, pay close attention to what other factors may be affecting or influencing the decision to play these types of transitions. Is the arrangement moving from a verse section to a coda section or vice versa? Or is the conga player simply answering or initiating a call in relation to the timbalero or bongocero while they're already in an up section? Now, if you want to know more about what we do on Conga Chops and how we can help you take your playing to the next level, come check us out at congachops.com. We've got an incredible library of step-by-step courses and lessons from beginner to pro, over 100 exclusive practice loops, and an amazing community forum where you can get one-on-one feedback on everything you're learning. Just click the link below to grab your free 7-day trial and see what it's all about. Now, don't forget to support our channel by giving this video a like, leaving a comment down below as to what you'd like to see me cover next, and hitting subscribe and turning on your notifications so you can catch a new video each week. I'll see you in the next lesson.